that the main reason why this country went into the IMF program in 2015 was because of some measly $930 million that you call a bailout. I'll be surprised if the Minister of Finance truly does believe that it's because of some paltry $930 million that this country actually went into an IMF program. I mean, I can understand if this is coming from a foot soldier out there, but for it to come from the Minister of Finance is absolutely unacceptable. Absolutely unacceptable. Because everybody does know that over the period 2015 and 2016, even the amount of investment that has been done in this country, investment, for example, that brought Dunso to an end, is way past $930 million. Investment that went into the road sector, investment that went into the educational sector, investment that went into our port and harbors, our airport and cable, you don't consider this $930 million measly money to be the reason why Ghana went to this. So obviously, Mr. Minister, you actually misled the house. Ghana did not go to IMF because of a bailout. That's the first one. The second one, Mr. Speaker, is to clarify also that this whole obsession that anytime a country goes to IMF, it means the economy has been mismanaged. You see? That's why some illumination needs to be obtained. Let me give you a typical example. In the year 2008, the NPP government had finished the IMF program, I think, by 2006. 2007 and 8 were 2 years that were post IMF. And Mr. Speaker, let me tell you the reality. In the year 2008, the NPP government had a plan to have a budget deficit of 4% and ended up having a budget deficit of about 15%. Missed the budget deficit by 11%. 4% was the target at the beginning of 2008. At the end of 2008, the budget deficit stood at 15%. That was missing it by 11%, the highest in the history of this country.